To piggyback a little bit off of what TJ Cox was saying, getting the political will out there. I spoke earlier about having employers benefit from this. You gotta start cutting the legs out from their arguments that are false. It's gonna save employers money. The other thing too is, oh, it's gonna be, you know, completely socialized medicine and stuff like that. If you're on Medicare, you know there's no such thing as a Medicare hospital and a Medicare doctor. You know, you're going to the same provider that you already have, and so you don't have to be scared about that stuff. When we come to the implementation of it as well, too, and transitioning as it, it's not just the healthcare system by itself. This is a national economic system. So if you go to my website, ricofranco.com, you'll see part of what I propose is bringing a medical school right in here to the Central Valley. And part of that, a full research-based medical school to research things like asthma and the health issues that we have. Bring more specialists here instead of having to travel to the Bay Area or LA for special medical issues, but also to create more providers. One of the biggest Medicare is the biggest portion of residencies in our medical school program right now to actually train new doctors. People don't realize that, but this is what we're gonna need in order to bolster that kind of healthcare system. And we have to make sure that we aren't leaving people out when we're training new doctors in terms of communities that we serve. One that came to light real recently is the transgender community. They seek certain healthcare needs right now and doctors aren't trained on how to deal with them. So it's imperative that we build more institutions like this so that they can actually study the specific healthcare needs of the communities that they have. And that includes the veterans as well, because I know that's a hot topic issue.